ambliFibre stands as an acronym for an adaptive model-based control for fiber-reinforced tape winding. So we took the tape winding process, which is already automated, and to achieve that need which is present in the industry, that need for mass production, for example in the automotive industry, we aimed at enhancing the process with a model-based control and developed certain features including quality control, adaptive human-machine interfacing and also life cycle modeling.
We've been working on laser-assisted tape winding for nearly 25 years. And we see the ambliFibre project as a major breakthrough, especially for industrial sectors which are dealing with energy.
One of those features is an inline monitoring device which can detect the degree of consolidation in the tape directly after the tapes are welded together. Our second objective was to build a smart machine interface based on data mining algorithms to give the operator some feedback about the process itself based on experience data. Then we wanted to model the process, so we wanted to build a simulation model of the process. The next position would be an adaptive laser optics and a fast camera for getting thermographic images, and then develop a holistic system which is both adaptable for continuous and discontinuous production. We had regular telephone calls within the work packages mostly. What is most important is the face-to-face meeting, in my opinion, and for that we had regular general assembly meetings.
Looking over the 3 years now and seeing the end result, we believe much, much more in its technology and in the feasibility of the product, as the design is much more robust and thought through. And by that, I think we had the chance to deliver a really, really good product into the ambliFibre project, and the whole team is hopefully satisfied with the result. Everything looks really promising, that the quality of the tank will be as expected.
We developed three different possible models. One is for continuous production, which is, for example, used for producing pipes, which could be several kilometers long, and also for discontinuous production, which is used for producing tanks. But our system technology is developed in a way that it is possible to have both a cell with a continuous and a discontinuous system.
This can help, hopefully, to make the move towards greener energy systems overall. We already had discussions with the end users, with our partners, to move on and to not stop after the public-funded project and to continue the joint development.